Hi everyone, so happy you took the time again to come over and watch a new video from Diane and me. And for everyone who is new here and sees me for the first time, my name is Yanni and I'm doing this channel together with my daughter-in-law Diane. And today I am so happy to tell you that we are co-hosting a beautiful challenge which is called a Tear Tray Challenge. And the beautiful host today is Sonja from the Domestic Diva Home. She has 3 beautiful channels. Of course, I will put a link down below for all her 3 beautiful channels, so go check it out. But today it is a tear tray challenge. I will have to do this many times over. But of course, everyone is asked to make a tray, a 1 tray, a tear tray, a 2, 3. It doesn't matter as long as you make a tear tray. So I will put a link down below with the playlist with tons of beautiful inspiration for your own tear tray. So go check it out. And of course, if you like Diane and my channel and you like the content, I hope you will consider subscribing to our channel too. It is sometimes a little bit chaos, but if you like that, you are more than welcome. So like I always say, let's jump into our DIY. So here you see already what I will use to make my 3-tier tray, but you see already it's one big chaos on my table. like I always said. But here you see I have some box signs, but I don't like the front of it anymore because it does not fitting in my decor for this year, and some old books I'm just going to make new. So I will have printed out with my magic some prints, and that I'm going to mod podge on my prints of all my books and all my signs. But I will do that out of camera because I think you already know how to mod podge it. So I will cut it out and just show it to you when they are finished. So here you see my 3-tier tray, and I have on a lazy Susan because it's a little bit easier for you to see. I don't get the angle quite right that you can see everything, but I hope the camera picks up everything. I did a lot of pieces already around me. What I always do when I do my 3-tier tray or 2, I always in front of it I already get some greenery, some picks, some everything I want to use, some clocks or everything what I want to use I already have on my table, and I already try things out. Because most of the time you have to do it 3 or 4 times before it's to my that I like it. So you see already I have some greenery, I have some other greenery, some red berries, I have a reindeer, I have some skates, some wooden beads, and you see here I will use a sleigh, and you see I have another one, but this one I already did a little bit of the gold with my gold pencil. You just see, I just got it from the Action. I think you can buy it with Dollar Tree, Dollarama, Poundland, doesn't matter. And I just distress it a little bit with the gold color, so it looks a little bit more old and used. So because it was a very white sleigh, like we in the Netherlands call it just a sleigh. I think you call it a sledge, if I'm call it that. That's in Dutch a really strange word. So most of the time I say sleigh. So you know what I mean with when I say sleigh, you know what I mean. I mean this one. And of course we have some skis already around here. I think you called it the same, if I am correct. And I have a little house, and of course I already have the house and I already have light in it, but I found it a little bit too black. So also this one I will distress a little bit with the gold color to give it a little bit more structure to it. So I will do that also, and then we are almost ready to decorate. So I did it out of camera because I think maybe you were bored, but I still want to show you a little bit that I just going inside of the little house, just inside of the windows, and just frame a little piece off with the gold color. So not a lot, but just give it a little bit more dimension so you can see a little bit more that it is a window. And I will do this also with the windows also over here. Just buy a cheap gold pen and you can just distress it a little bit, just go a little bit beside the corners, just give it a little bit more structure to your piece. And you can do a little bit more here in his chimney, just a little piece over here. And of course, this is my preference, you don't have to do it. This is just a little bit of an idea how you can distress it a little bit more exact. You can also distress it with paint, but this time I chose for to do a little bit of the gold color you see already, and I will do the windows over here, but I will do that out of camera. So what I always do first is place my bigger piece, because I have a little reindeer, and of course he looks a little, but if you have him in your stand it is already very big. And of course he has the need most of the time when I move him around, because this is my dinner table. He always have the urge to go to go down, so most of the time I just do some sticky gum under his feet, just little pieces. And just, I think you all have some little pieces of glue dots, if I am correct. That's not something what we have here. So I want to have this in front of me, so now I'm sticking him to the tea tray. And what I will do, because I will use also some skis, and of course I will use this one, and of course I will cut this off because I don't need the rope. So I hope you still can see it. So just some skis, and I also do a little of sticky gum under it, under the ski, because I want that he stays at the same place when I move him around. And of course I want this one to stand up, so I'm hoping that it will stay this way, but this is not the way he thinks about it right now. He has something I don't stay, he doesn't have the urge to stay. So I will stick this also, at least I try a little bit that he will stick this way. I will turn my, and this is what I mean, that never everything goes the way you want it to, because the sticks are not really working with me today, and I really want them that they stand upright. So I do want to have them over here. So just a piece of sticky gum and just place it. But I thought maybe I had enough on one, but I don't think I have enough on one sticky gum. So place them over here, but I don't know if I find the skis not too short, because I like it a little bit longer. So you see I have now two items already in my display, and what you do, you can see already when you would do now some greenery, you already see how much your top already changes. Only when you do two pieces and just do some greenery and you're already fit to go. But I still doing some I think maybe a sign or a little piece between it. So see, I did the skis over here, but I think I move them a little bit more to the side, and I just do some bell with it. So just move things a little bit to the side, and this one and also this one. So I think now he looks a little bit better. I hope you can see it. You see just here a simple reindeer, some bell, and of course some little wooden skis you can get everywhere. What I will do right now is also my first sign I made new. I just mud podged it, so it is, for me it's new because I made it on my own. So it's a unique piece. I place it inside of here, And now I will have, I think, my little globe. He was also €2, similar like $2, so he was very cheap. So I really find it very cute for on my tea tray. And I know you see the back side of the sign, but I will work that away with my greenery in a moment. And what I will do probably is do this sleigh. I don't know if I get him inside of here or I have to move him this way. Or I have to, I hope he can stand upright, but it's always just fitting and looking what is will work or not. But I don't think this time, well, so I have to move him and I don't want that. So I think I don't think another side is also not, I can try just to squeeze it in, but I don't think that's really the option to do. So I wish I just got it a little bit under it, so I just, but he really does not go on it, so I will do him on the side, so a little bit this way, but also I just do a little piece of gum on the underside here of my sleigh, so he sticks a little bit better in my tray, because or else he will be moving around when I move my tray, but he's not really sticking that well. And I really need to, you have to take your time for that, because I'm really sorry that I have to do it in front of you, but you really need to make the time for it. And what I see right now, that I just, when I moved it, I just saw that one piece, a little piece of for my tray turned from the paint is going off, so I take a black marker and I just make it black again, because I don't like it when they have a lot of pieces of it. So for now I am going to get him on here. So now we are going to do the underside, and of course I will do my house, and of course I have some lights already in them. I have another light. I do two of the IKEA vaccine lights, if you think you call it. Here in the Netherlands we call it vaccinelichtje. So I have two vaccinelichtjes inside of it. So and now I have to squeeze this one also in, because he's also not really happy to go inside of my tray. But I already had him earlier inside, so he has to fit. He really has to fit. So yes, now I need the other one, of course. So I have to do the lights right, and you see I think I moved this a little bit, because there still needs some books in it. And what I do also in front of it, I hope you still can see it off camera, on camera, what I will do, I have here some nutcrackers. They are also from the Action, and they were only a couple of years ago, they were only I think 79 cents. I just got the top of my nutcracker, and of course I will place one over here and one over here, because I want it a little bit more fuller. Is that a word, fuller? I don't know, in here in the Netherlands we call it voller. So I just do one of them over here, just also with a little sticky gum, and of course the top again, I just cut it off. And most of the time I just do with a red marker, I just do his top, so the gold will disappear. So, and I do one over here, so they will be in the same direction. So you see, every time I forget that is Lazy Susan, that I can turn the tray around. You already see now if you see right now, you just see some crowded, but it does come okay. It will, at the end, it will be fine. Now what we're going to do is, I still have some ice skates, and I also want to do this too inside of it. Maybe is a way that I can do them on top of my sleigh. Maybe I can do it with some, just stick them together, and just with a little piece of gum I can stick this one also on top of it. So you see, I did the ice skates also with a little gold of my pencil. I just accented a couple of pieces of the skates, and of course I did with some sticky gum, I pulled them together. So, and I placed them on top of my little sleigh. So you saw, doing my house inside of my little farmhouse. Yeah, the little farm. I just bought it in a thrift store only for 2 years already, because last summer, so already a little while back, I just bought this one. What I'm going to do, I just changed my book, and he still needs to dry a little bit. So I do this one inside of it. I'm just laying it on the side, just inside of it, so you still can see a little piece of my book. And what I'll do with this is my clock. I bought it from IKEA. I think he was $4.99, if I am correct. But I like that it gives a little bit of the old-fashioned way. And of course, I will turn it a little bit around. I will place him inside of here. So most of the time, I have three pieces in one row, at least for now. But now I'm still going to work with some nutcrackers, because this is a little bit of the theme of my home, is the nutcracker. So I still also going to cut this one off and do it with some red marker. I have somewhere a red marker, you see here, and I just tap it on his head just to make sure that everything what's been gold is been red. This is a very easy trick, just to work away some pieces of your figurine or something what you use. And of course, again, some sticky gum under it, and just place them beside the clock. And I have another one over here. For people who doesn't like to see what I'm doing and it's taking much too long for them, just like I always say, skip forward. I understand that. So, for everyone who still likes to see how I am really struggling to get the way I wanted to, because I am really a person, it has to be really my taste, or else I just pull everything out again. So, you have fun those days. The one day it's everything is, you just pull it together, and there are days you can do it 10 times, 20 times, and it will never work. So most of the time you still can put it away. So you see here, I have now here my and what I did, you see already what I did wrong. If you see here, I have here my nutcrackers, but if you look here, I have them already also over here. So if you want to do a little piece that you can all sides look a little bit interesting, you have to turn the decoration a little bit further. So I will take this one out, and what I will do is just move everything a little bit so that my clock will change. You see, now a little bit further, and also a little bit more here. And now you see already my clock is over here, and if I do now the nutcrackers, the other nutcrackers will be over here. So even with that, I am thinking about, you can call it crazy, you can call it anything, but that's the way I decorate. It has to be fitting of all places. Now I am lost my another nutcracker, he is gone. So I'm going to look for him, and I see you in a moment. Only already I have him. He is on my plate. Of course, you probably already saw him, but I didn't. So this is one, and this is one besides of the clocks. But you see, now you have one over here, and I'm going to try, if I am at least over here, just cut this one off again and mark his head. So he will be totally red. And a little piece of sticky gum. And then we already a little bit at the time where we can almost go to our, I will have to squeeze him in. And of course I want to stick him, because I don't want him to move. You see already, if I would do it correctly, he would have stood here over here. This, maybe I will do that. Still, I will cut this off, and maybe I can have it this way that I can squeeze him also under my sleigh and just squeeze him in just here. Now I have him a little bit more equal with the rest of it. This one this way, this one this way. I still need to do my little globe. He still needs some sticky gum. I think what you have is a little bit easier to work with, because sticky gum is, you have to bend it. So now I think he is already looking great, and I also, the only thing I need right now is the little book, but he's still drying. I need a little book over here, the same like we have here. I want to have one over here, so everything is coming back to it again. And then I show you before we go to do the greenery in, so you can see already how crazy I am, because I already have my reindeer out again, because the book was not at the place I needed to be. So this one over here and the book over here. So I have one over here, some sign over here, and some book over here. Now it's all in triangle. Yeah, triangle if I'm in threes. Most of the pieces I buy always are in pairs or in more than one piece. So now I think we are ready fit to go to work our way with some greenery. I'm debating if I like a little bit of this clocks, but I don't know yet, but we will see. But first we're going to do the greenery, and then you will see how he will change, because it's one chaos right now, but believe me, in a moment it will come to it will calm down, and you will see that everything comes to life. At least I hope so. So I am hoping that you see everything okay. I try to do my best, so you can see how much everything will change just because you put some greenery inside of it. And I am going to just, where it does fit okay, there is where I'm going to do my greenery. And of course, if it's too big, just cut it off. And I am just working my way behind the back of my sign, because you know that was open. So I am going to work away with that. Now I'm going to do something under my sleigh, because I don't want you that you look inside of the sleigh. So, and these are all, everything is all branches. So just always keep your branches. You will see you can use them time and time again. And I'm just turning it around and just doing where I think it's fitting and where I think it needs a little bit of the. I also, every time I have picks of them with three of them, which of course you can pick them out and you can do it another way. And I do one over here and one this way. But you see here, there's some plastic on it. I will cut this off because I don't like that you see that on your tray. So Most of the time I try to get it that it looks a little bit more natural, because I think always a tray or a piece what you made must come to life, and I really find it very important that it is. I'm doing one over here and just keep turning around, and I'm still hoping that you still, when I turn around, you can see it. So I do squeeze a one over here inside of it, and I think that you already see a little bit what I will, what I mean. I need some loose pieces because I need some little ones. I need to cut this one off, then it will fit a little bit better just beside the nutcracker. One over here, and I have another one, a little one. I just keep pulling off the plastic to make it more natural. Sorry. So, and you see already my skis are already falling, so I give them a little piece of greenery that he will stick a little bit better. So I will squeeze this one in, so I hope that he will stick a little bit better right now. Now I need a little piece over here, and also again remove your plastic, like we call it here, and of course we're going to have a couple of, again, some smaller pieces just fitting over here. This can be a bigger piece because this is already, I will look if I can squeeze it in. And I need a bigger piece over here, I already see. And just work your way inside of your tray. And of course I can do a little piece in front of my sign, but I will do that, but I do not a really big one. I do two pieces in one opposite directions. I will do a piece of plastic out of it, and I will do a little bit more over here and a little bit more over here, because I still want to see the sign, and I need one of the bottoms so it will stick this way, because most of the time, or else he will fall off. And I lay one of on the bottom so it will be stuck right here. And I think already we already a lot where we needed to be, because I need some loose pieces, one and one over here, one here. Just cut the plastic off. I hope I still do everything on camera. I really have no idea. I hope that I placed you right. That's something I really need to learn, to get a great view for you all, because sometimes it's not always the best way to see. But if you have questions, just ask me. I will love to answer your questions. This is a little bit from this piece of my greenery. I need some piece over here and a bigger one over here, but I need that loose. So I will do one over here and one over here. Then when you have them separate from each other, it's a little bit easier to work with. So first do the bigger pieces, you just squeeze it in, and the little holes, just do a little piece of it. So you see here, I just need a little piece over here because he is very open, but I don't need a big piece, so just work your way inside of it. So you already see it comes to life, and now we are going to are ready for the next greenery. That will be this piece of greenery, and another piece of Christmas greenery. You can use any greenery you want, because I saw on the Dollar Tree site we have I can watch the Dollar Tree website, but I can buy from it, but that's okay. But we don't have here, I just make it. But I just saw that they have really great greenery. So if you want to do it on a budget like we do, just go to that kind of places. But I think a lot of you already will go to the Dollar Tree. Just work some different greenery inside of your piece. And I, like you see me every time do, just cut off the plastic and just do a branch over here. Just squeeze it in. It just has to mingle with each other. And that is the way that your piece will come to life. How more you work with different branches. And I really love to use green branches. I am really a person from the natural tones. But if you like a little bit more from the colors or something else, just do the way you think it's right. And just another piece. And again, I'm just looking where I can squeeze this one in, because I will also on this right side I want to have. And you see already he is changing up so much only with some greenery. I'm sorry for people if it takes too long. If you are bored and you just want to skip forward. And you see here I have, I think I need here a little piece, little piece, not just a big one. This one, yes, it's okay, it's possible. But of course, if you need a smaller piece, just cut them, and you just need a smaller piece. You see here I have a little smaller piece, and I already see already that he is quietly fitting over here. And now I will have one over here. I have one over here. I think I squeeze one under here, because I really like this greenery. And again, removing the plastic. And I'm just looking for places where I need to. I need one over here. And of course some new. You see, this was a brand I bought. He was so longer. So, and I just pull everything off. And you are having so much fun for one branch. You can do so many with it. So one over here. And a piece of. And I'm just looking if I missed something. I think I will do one over here. I will, of course, the let I not forget is first I will do a bigger piece over there. I just cut this one off. At least I try. But my hands are not the greatest. At least not when it how it was in the early days, we already always say. But we are doing our best. So, a little piece over here. And you see, it looks a lot, but it doesn't. It is not a lot. If you take it off, you will see it is not a lot. But you see already how your piece is coming to life. But you see already over there, I just need some piece. And so you are working your way inside also of your greener. You have to look it on all sides, so you don't see a hole. you don't see an open space. I think that's a little bit better when I say a little open space. So I am also doing one over here and a little piece. If I have some loose branches, I have one over here already. And I do one over here. So also this will be filled up. And I see here the middle is closed. Maybe I need one open branch. So this will be over here. I will place one over here. So I think we are almost fit to do the red berries in it. I show you that in a moment. So you see, everything is with green. What I'm going to do now as the last touch, what I will do is do some red berries on a couple of pieces, not a lot, because I don't want it to have it too red. So I just need some couple of pieces. So you see, I just take a little bush and just work a little bit, some touches over here. And I just do a couple of them because I don't want too much. But if you like it, of course, you're free to do as many as you want, of course. But I think I will do one over here. And I hope I can squeeze it in. And you just, sometimes you have to get your, work your way into it. So. And another piece, and then for me it's already more than enough. I just pull this one also down to make it a little bit more like one branch again. I have to look where I want to have it. Maybe here I'm really debating where I want to have it, because I don't really find a nice spot that I like it. Maybe over here or here. You see already still some couple of pieces I need to take off. So maybe in this way. So I don't know if I like it a little bit better if I just do a little instead of such a big piece. Maybe I just do some little touches. I really don't know. I will look for it. If I see this, I think I like that a little bit more than just one big piece. So maybe I just need to cut a couple of them to make them a little bit smaller. So this one is a little bit more smaller, because I think, or else it will be a little bit too big. Now we are going to do one over here, so now it's a little bit more in balance. And I do just a little piece of two little ones also over here. Just lay them on top of it, just to give it also a little bit color. So I will make this one a little bit smaller. At least I think I will, but maybe, I don't know. That's, you see just what I mean. You just have to puzzle a little bit, just take your time for it and take your moment for it, so you will find the right way where you will have them. So take the time. And if you want to, you also can glue it with some pieces of glue gun, but I don't do that because I want to use the greenery again. So I will find a couple of spots more and then I show you the end result. So here you see how my 3-tier tray turned out. I am so happy how he's, oh sorry, I'm so happy how he's looking like, and I have him on my wooden tray on my dinner table. That's why I need to stick everything together, because we are using this table a lot. And you see here, I have in the corner, I have my IKEA Christmas tree. You saw already a couple of times more for $9.99. Of course, the reindeers I have already for years, and they were only €2. Similar, like I said, like dollars. This one I bought on clearance last year, the Nutcracker. I have them in several of sizes. So you will see them around my decor this year. I'm very happy with it. Here you see a little wooden tree, and I glued some red berries on it because I think it's fitting more a little bit with my decor, and it gives a little bit more Christmassy feeling. And then here you see my three-tier tray. And you see here my book with the Santa on it. And just giving a little bit back of the buffalo check, but not too much. You see here a couple of the nutcrackers. And of course, here another reindeer. And I also did some pieces of gold on it. So, I will take you a little bit around. That's always, I wish sometimes that there was a little lazy Susan I could find, that I can turn my three-tier tray around, but I never found one of them. So you see here an old vintage Christmas tree I printed on some buffalo check paper and just do it on a sign block. And you see here I also have two nutcrackers over here and my little farm I drifted. And you see, just with the touches of gold, you just see the windows a little bit better than when you have them totally black. And now we are going to do this side with the little globe, and of course here my nutcracker wooden book and my globe, my sleigh, and of course my IKEA clock. I am really happy how my three-tier tray turned out. I will show you in a couple of shots better. But for everyone who stuck with me all this time, I'm so happy you made it to the end, like I always say. And I am sorry if I'm rambling a little Dutch and English to each other, so maybe you learn also a little bit of the Dutch language. So, but most of the time when I'm decorating, sometimes I forget I have to speak English. So, but I hope you will forgive me. So, I will do a couple of shots picture shots for you for my 3-tier tray. But I had fun making it, and I hope you take a little bit of inspiration with you just to make one of your own, and that you saw how easy it is just to make with a couple of pieces, make one of your own. And you see, with the greenery, everything comes back to life again. So this is what how it looked like together. So, but I'm so happy you did this together with me. I love to show you how I make my things, because like I always say, I'm also an amateur, so if I can do it, you can do it. So this was my 3-tier tray for this challenge. I had so much fun making it. And of course, Sonja, thank you so much for hosting this. And I am so grateful that I could have been your co-host. So thank you so much for that. And please, everyone, go check all the beautiful creators out, because there are so many beautiful creators who give you so many inspirations. So go check the playlist out. And of course, like I always say, if you like our content from Diane and me, and there will be a lots of more beautiful Christmas videos in the future. So go subscribe to our channel. You're more than welcome. And of course, from the enemy, we wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and take care of each other. And we hope to see you in a new video. Love from the enemy. Bye, everyone.